Hey guys, in this lesson, we're going to learn about the New Deal, its policies, its critics, and its effects. So this screen recording has three parts: the New Deal's policies, the opponents of the New Deal, and the impacts of the New Deal. Here's part one, the New Deal's policies. The U.S. government had three policies when it incorporated the New Deal, and the three policies were the relief, the recovery, and the reform of the economy. These were the goals that these policies had. President Roosevelt and the Congress wanted to accomplish these three goals by creating worker programs, by reforming the banking and business practices that had been in effect up to this point, instituting new government programs, and promoting the economic recovery of the country. The U.S. government intervened in the economy to create jobs by installing new programs like these five that I have here on the screen, including the Tennessee Valley Authority, called the TVA, the Civilian Conservation Corps, or CCC, the Civil Works Administration, or CVA, the Public Works Administration, or PWA, and the Works Progress Administration, called the WPA. I know there's a lot of letters in those, and critics like this cartoonist made fun of the many initials of the programs that the New Deal had. So here's Roosevelt in the cartoon, and here's some of those initials of those programs. President Hoover had actually attempted some stuff before the New Deal happened, and in 1932, he approved the creation of the RFC, or Reconstruction Finance Corporation, which was a government office that was trying to help out with the Great Depression. The role of the RFC was a government agency that was tasked with authorizing loans to large businesses that had suffered losses as a result of the Great Depression. The agency actually continued to operate throughout the Great Depression and World War II. Opponents of the New Deal is the second part of this presentation. The opponents of the New Deal were basically arguing that the New Deal made the federal government way too powerful, and that it overregulated businesses, and that it restricted people's individual freedoms by restricting businesses. So here's a diagram that can help you remember this. If you look at this glove here on the left, you'll see that it's representing a government all powerful and strong. And here's the businesses all weak with the blue glove, all small. Now, opponents of the New Deal, like this cartoonist, argued that the federal government was growing way too much. So here's Roosevelt with this really powerful bowl here. And here's the Congress, or the lawmakers of our country, weak and small. Opponents of the New Deal thought that we should do different things. For example, this is Senator Huey Long, and he was for the redistribution of wealth, otherwise known as his Share Our Wealth plan. And Senator Huey Long actually died when he was campaigning for this plan, but it's one of the earliest forms of socialism that we've ever seen in America. The opponents of the New Deal included other people like Francis Townsend, who was a doctor from California, and he argued for a pension plan that was going to require people receiving those pension plan payments to spend the money immediately. That way we could help the economy. Though the plan was never instituted, it did set the stage for a later program that Roosevelt called the Social Security Act. Opponents of the New Deal basically advocated that the government should intervene to protect the economy and to protect businesses. So these were opponents that thought that maybe the government wasn't doing enough, so it ought to do more. It ought to make sure that it intervenes more than what it was already intervening. The impacts of the New Deal is the last part here, and these are some of the impacts that the New Deal had on our nation. The New Deal created various new agencies and new programs, like, for example, FDIC, which is the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation. This insurance company, this insurance corporation, insured the deposit accounts at member banks for up to $250,000 per account. And it continues to provide that insurance to today. So it provides stability to our banking industry. The SEC is the second New Deal agency that was created, and it's called the Securities and Exchange Commission, and it continues to regulate the stock market and businesses, and it insures against fraud in things like cryptocurrency nowadays. And the Social Security Administration is another program from the New Deal, and it continues to provide income on a steady monthly basis to elderly people in America as they retire. These government posters, for example, like this one from the 1930s, advocated for people in America to join the Social Security Administration so they could get a payment when they're 65, when they retire. The New Deal had a lot of impacts on our nation, but the passage of this New Deal legislation marked a significant change in the role of the federal government in the lives of Americans. The New Deal policies administered grants to state governments to implement programs, and it established a significant role for the government involvement in stabilizing the economy at both the state and the federal level. President Roosevelt's attempt to increase the number of Supreme Court justices, though, from 9 to 13, would have created a shift in the separation of powers, which means that it would have made the executive branch much more powerful than the judicial branch. And we can't have that in America because we have a system called checks and balances since the creation of our nation and our U.S. Constitution. The legislation or laws of the New Deal were challenged a lot in court, especially in the Supreme Court, because there was a concern that the federal government's executive branch was growing too much and it infringed on the power of the individual states. So Roosevelt attempted to increase the number of Supreme Court justices because he thought that it could help him. This, though, could be viewed as an increase in executive power at the expense of the judicial branch, like I mentioned earlier. The impact that this had is that it divided the Democratic Party, and some Democrats supported Roosevelt while others did not, but it also hindered his work and it stopped him from passing important legislation. Here's a Supreme Court cartoon from that time and the Supreme Court rulings that had declared New Deal programs unconstitutional are being shown in this cartoon. The artist also shows Roosevelt trying to encourage a reluctant judge here to pass programs in his New Deal. And when President Roosevelt suggested increasing the number of Supreme Court justices, critics like this cartoonist here argued that it was an attack against the very foundation of American democracy. So that's why this big thug here is pushing this pillar. And that's it. These are the summaries that I have for you here for today's lesson. So remember, the New Deal policies were designed to provide relief, recovery, and reform to America's citizens and businesses. But opponents of the New Deal included both liberals who wanted more government intervention and conservatives who wanted less intervention from the government. Overall, there were impacts that the New Deal had, but it created programs that still impact Americans today, including the Social Security Act and the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation. I hope you learned something new today.